Hi, my name is Alicia Dion Wild Goose, better known as Wonderful Wild Goose. I attend the Freeport Seventh-day Adventist Church, and week after week, I have the awesome privilege of telling all the kids from Kidz Konnect a story about Jesus. I hope that week after week, these stories brings you closer to Jesus. This Christmas, there's so much to be thankful for. And this Christmas season, I am thankful for having the opportunity with connecting with each one of you. It is my prayer that we take time to reflect and give thanks in this year 2020 and hope for a better year in 2021. I love you all and look forward to many, many more episodes on Kidz Konnect. Remember, what time is it? It's story time.
Lord, if we could, we will fill our hearts with all the wonderful things you have given us. Then we will lift them back to you. Everything I am, everything I am, all you've given me, all you've given me, I give it to you, Lord, I give it to you, Lord, and do it thankfully, thankfully. Every song I sing, every praise I bring, everything I do is a gift to you.
Hi, my name is Elijah Elvis. I thank for all of my toys.
My name is Terea Elvis. I am grateful for many things, but I am most grateful for my family, teachers, and friends.
You are my strength when I am weak. You are the treasure that I seek. You are my all in all. Seeking you as a precious jewel. Lord, to give up, I'd be your fool. You are my all in all. Use for smelekem kalem. Use for kokim apcheche. Use to
a couple of weeks ago, I wrote a list of things I wanted to get for Christmas. But instead, my parents challenged me to write a list of names of people who I wanted to give a gift to. Now on Christmas Day, I will give gifts to those people. I am excited to know that I will be making others happy. That's what Christmas means to me.
Your baby would one day walk on water. Oh, Mary, did you know that your baby boy would save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy has come to beg you? The child that you deliver will soon deliver you.
Mary, did you know that your baby boy will give sight to a blind man? Mary, did you know that your baby boy will calm the storm with his hand? Did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels trod? When you kiss your little baby, you kiss the face of God. Mary, did you know?
The blind will see, the deaf will hear, the dead will live again. The lame will leap, the dumb will sleep, the praises of the Lamb. Oh Mary, did you know
that your baby boy is Lord of all creation? Mary, did you know that your baby boy will one day rule the nations? Did you know that your baby boy is heaven's perfect lamb? The sleeping child you're holding is the great I am.
Oh Mary, did you know?
Season greetings, boys and girls. This is the season to share joy, love, peace, and happiness. Boys and girls, we want you to be happy this season. But remember, boys and girls, that Jesus is the reason for this season. So he is love. So let us spread love to everyone. And happy holidays, boys and girls.
All the other gods, they are the works of men. You are the Most High God, there is none like you. All the other gods, they are the works of men. You are the Most High God,
There is none like you,
Jehovah.
You are the Most High. You are the Most High God,
Jehovah.
You are the Most High. You are the Most High God.
You are good and your mercy is forever.
Hallelujah.
You are good and your mercy is forever.
Hallelujah.
Jehovah.
You are the Most High. You are the Most High God.
Jehovah.
You are the Most High. You are the Most High God.
Thank you for my mommy, my grammy, my compi and nano. Happy holiday and Merry Christmas, everyone.
Christmas, that we're going to have a good time, and I just want to say Merry Christmas and Happy New Year.
Good evening, boys and girls. Happy Sabbath and Merry Christmas. I am Terrific Tammy, and I hope you all had an amazing day with your family and loved ones. I hope you all got all the gifts that you wanted today, but I don't want you to forget the reason we celebrate this day. Christmas is not about all the gifts you received today. It's about the gift we received many, many years ago in a little town called Bethlehem. Christmas is a time when we celebrate the birth of Jesus, who came to earth as a baby so that one day he could later die for our sins. Just as the shepherds worshipped him and the angels sang praises to him, we should do the same and celebrate his birthday by giving him the greatest gift that you can give, your heart. Love you guys, and enjoy the rest of the Sabbath, and have a happy and prosperous New Year.
Hi, my name is Victoria Patrick, and I'm thankful for life. I'm thankful that I got to live. 2020 has been a tragic year, but I am thankful for life.
Valencia here, wishing you a merry, merry, merry Christmas. I hope you all are enjoying your Christmas break. Listen, I am so proud of all of you who have been working with Kidz Konnect. You've been participating. You've been learning about God, learning about yourself, and learning how we all should live together. And I know that you all have been putting that to good practice in your life every day. I want to wish you and your families a Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays, Happy New Year, and I'm praying for all of you. Always remember that God has a plan for your life. Every single one of you, God has a plan for you. Bye.
My name is Victory Kate, and I thank you for all of my friends and my family.
Mary, did you know that your baby boy will one day walk on water? Mary, did you know that your baby boy will save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you new? This child that you deliver will soon deliver you. Mary, did you know that your baby boy will give a sight to a blind man? Mary, did you know that your baby boy will calm a storm with his hand? Did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels trod? And when you kiss your little baby, you kiss the face of God. Oh, Mary, did you know? Oh, Mary, Mary, did you know? Oh, the blind will see, the deaf will hear, the dead again. The lame will leap, the dumb will speak the praises of the Lamb. Oh, Mary, did you know?
Happy Sabbath, everybody. Happy Sabbath. It is that time. It is story time. Now, I've asked you last week, and I'm asking you again this week, what was the name of last week's story? What was the name of last week's story? Let me see if Kelsey and Killian can get it. Let me see if Lewis can. Enoch, do you know what is the name of last week's story? Again, we've been talking about the birth of Christ. And last week, the name of the story was The Shepherds Worship Jesus. The shepherds worship Jesus. And today we have another story that kind of culminates it all, brings it all together. And again, it is about the birth of Jesus. And do you know what today's story, the name of today's story is? You know what it is? I'm going to tell you after I ask you a question. The question I always ask, the question you don't want to ask, the question you want me to ask. And that question is... And the name of this story is Gifts for Baby Jesus. Gifts for Baby Jesus. Now, do you like to get presents? Well, let me answer that question. I normally ask you the question. I want to answer it. I like to get presents. Do you like to get presents? Most people do. And a long time ago, some men gave special gifts to Jesus. It may have been like this. I see it. I see it. The man looking into the night sky was suddenly very excited. What do you think? He asked the man with him. It could be the sign we've been looking for, answered one of his friends. Together, the men talked about the new star that they had been studying. These men were the Magi, men known in their country as honest and wise. Although they were not Jews, they had studied the Hebrew scriptures and learned about a special star. That star meant it was time for the Messiah to be born. So when the bright new star appeared in the night sky, they rejoiced. They were sure that the sign was of the Messiah, the Savior. After much discussion, some of the wise men decided to follow the star. Traveling at night to keep the star in sight, the men journeyed for many days. They kept studying the scriptures as they went, and God's Holy Spirit guided them. After many weeks of travel, the star stopped over Jerusalem. The wise men expected to find everyone walking and talking about the birth of the new king. "Where is he who was born, the king of the Jews?" they asked. "And we have seen the big star. We have come to worship him." But strangely, no one seemed to know anything about it. Before long, King Herod heard about the strangers and their questions. He wanted to know more, so he sent for them. "Sir, can you direct us to the Jewish king who has been born?" asked one of the men. "We have come to worship him." Now, Herod knew that he was not well liked by his subjects, and the idea of a new king made him angry and jealous. But he pretended to be interested so he could find out more. Before answering the men from the east, Herod questioned the Jewish priests and the scribes. They reported that scripture said the Messiah would be born in Bethlehem. And Herod then told the wise men, "Go to Bethlehem and search for the child. And when you find him, come and tell me. Because you know why? I want to worship him too." Do you think that Herod wanted to worship him? Let's find out. Soon, the wise men arrived in Bethlehem, and there they found the place where the little family was staying. But no royal guard stood nearby. There was nothing at all to show the world that the child was special. They wondered, can this be the Messiah that we were looking for? And at first, it didn't seem possible. But when the wise men saw the baby, they knew. This Jesus was truly a Savior. And they bowed down and they worshipped him. And they gave him costly gifts to Mary and Joseph. Gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Soon, it was time to leave. The Magi planned to go back to Jerusalem to share the good news with King Herod. But in a dream, God told them not to go there. Wicked King Herod really wanted to harm the baby, not to worship him. So they went home another way. We can worship Jesus just as the wise men did. We can give him our time and our talents. We can give gifts of money and other things. But most of all, we must give him our hearts. And tell me, what will your special gift of worship be for Jesus? What will you give for Jesus? Back then, he got gifts of frankincense and myrrh and gold. But I want to know, what will you do for Jesus? Happy Sabbath, everybody. And I can't wait to give you another story. Goodbye and happy Sabbath. Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas.
Thank you for this love. Everyone, our scripture fund is taken from Matthew 2 verse 11. They saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him. Matthew 2 verse 11. They saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him. Matthew 2 verse 11. Happy Sabbath.
Despite all of the many things that happened in 2020, there's a lot of things to be thankful for. I am thankful for food and a roof over my head.
Merry Christmas, boys and girls. It's Joyful Julie here. We have so much to be thankful for. Jesus is a gift sent for each of us. Remember to accept him into your heart. Keep celebrating the gift of salvation.
Hello, everyone. My name is Mariano Ute. Today, I'm going to tell you things that I'm thankful for. Do you see all these things that are around us? And guess who made them? God. So, do you know that God is an awesome God? And also, do you know that if you scrape your leg or break your bone, isn't it amazing how it just heals itself? Only God can do that. And you know God could have just given us vegetables, greens, and water to drink, but no, he gave us all this delicious food that we all can enjoy. That's what I'm thankful for God for.
Hello, boys and girls. It's Natalie Nadine, and can you believe we've already come to the end of another year? God has been so good to us, boys and girls, to you and to me. I just want to say to you that just like how God had an eternal plan, he sent his one son, his son was born as a baby, came into this world to save us with a specific purpose. God has made each one of you with a specific purpose. And boys and girls, as we you roll into a brand new year, I want you to focus and ask the Lord what that purpose is. Ask Him what that purpose is, boys and girls, and ask Him to give you the strength to fulfill that purpose. You weren't made as a random creation. You were made specifically for a specific purpose to build up the kingdom of God. I want to wish you and your family the best of everything for this holiday season and just beautiful things all through the year 2021. I pray that we'll be able to see you, boys and girls, again. And it's been such a wonderful pleasure just spending these few months with you on Kidz Konnect. We'll see you soon.
Bow your head and close your eyes. Dear Heavenly Father, make us have the best Christmas we ever had. Help us to remember your death and your risen to heaven. Help us to be good. Cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Thank you. Thank you for everything that you have done. Thank you. Thank you for forgiving us of our sins. Take us to heaven with you at the end of time. Thank you for your Holy Spirit for comforting us in a broken heart. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Happy holidays from all of us here at Kidz Konnect.